Hi guys, it's TKD Gal here, and I am here with an unboxing and a live demo of the new nail kit that I just picked up. And it is the Sensationail Gel Manicure Kit for home. It says that there are 10 complete manicures in this box, 3 easy steps, no drying time, super glossy, all that. So what I thought I would do was show you guys what was inside the box. Now I already plugged in the little lamp because, you know, my little setup has changed, so I had to make sure that, you know, I could reach it on this new setup. So I already unplugged that, and it comes with your Sensationail Pro 3060 LED lamp, which is right here. And it is super, super bright. I plugged it in just to make sure it works and everything is fine. So I have that set up right here. And then it also comes with this little box here. And inside this box we have, our Sensationail So we have instructions, which are very important. And we have a two-sided nail buffer. Sorry about my phone, guys. Don't you hate it? You're filming and then everybody wants to text you. So we have our nail file and buffer. One side is smoother than the other one is a little bit rougher. And then we have a cuticle stick, a little wooden cuticle stick. And we have, these must be the lint-free wipes. I'm not sure how many are in here. I would say probably 10 or so. So we'll see. And then I also have, what else is in here? Let me open up this side of the box. Okay, so we have the clear transparent coat so that we have our top coat. Look how tiny this is. This is just ridiculous. Look, it's just tiny, it's little. So it says gel base and top coat. Right there, gel base and top coat. And then we have, I assume this next one's going to be our color. So raspberry wine is our color coat. Raspberry wine. And then we have some other little bottles in here. Let's see what else we have in here. We have, what is this? Sensationail gel primer. So it comes with its own little primer. Oh, there's a lot of little bottles coming out of here. Now I'm getting nervous. Can I do this? And there's another bottle in here that is not coming out. Oh, okay. All right, so this is the gel cleanser. Little tiny gel cleanser. And I've been watching a lot of videos on how girls are doing this, and from what I understand, this is probably just alcohol. So the Sensationail kit by Nailene, I think that's how you say it, has more than like, okay, so I went on their website and you see how they have all these shades on the side here. When you go to their website, they probably have maybe like 30 more different shades. So if this works out, I will pick up a couple more shades. Like there's a really beautiful teal blue color, and there's like a sparkly purple and a rose gold, and you know, some really interesting colors. So we shall see if this works out. So first thing I need to do is undo this manicure right here, and what I have on my nails is the Sally Hansen Triple Shine. And this is in Red Snapper. So this is kind of a orange red, very, very, kind of like a tomato-y red. And I've had this on for about 4 days, and you can see that this finger right here is starting to chip. This one right here is starting to chip on the sides too. This one, this nail broke a little bit, so. All right, so first thing I'm gonna do is remove my nail polish, clean my nails, you know, do any cuticle maintenance that needs to be done. So when I come back, I'll be ready to start the polish, okay? All right. Okay, guys, I'm back. So I went ahead and I removed the polish from my nails, and I just kind of very, very, very lightly shaped my nails. But we're going to go on to step number one, which is file and lightly buff the natural nail. So all the videos that I've been watching about gel manicures, no matter if it was a Sally Hansen kit, the Sensationail, red carpet, you know, gelish, they all say that you should buff kind of the natural shine off your nails away. So in this instructions, it says to use the pink side to do that. So I'm just going to go ahead and just kind of buff the natural shine away. And it's important that you buff it like from back to front and not side to side, because the nail plate grows from front to back. And if you do it from side to side, some people say it could cause ridges and things like that. So I don't know if that's true, but I'm just going to go on the safe side and just kind of just buff from front to back until the natural shine is gone, so it's nice and matte. So I'm just going to apply it to just the edges here. And I don't know if there's anything on the brush. Okay, hold on. Hold on. There we go. Just a little bit. It smells kind of alcohol-y. Just kind of get it right there. Just kind of around the tip there, around. Now, the thing that makes me nervous about this whole gel polish thing is that I am not the best painter. Like, I can always, you know, paint inside the lines. Wait a minute, I think I'm supposed to only do my thumb first. Okay, already messing up. Okay, well, let me just finish this since I've already done this part. I don't know if I'm gonna have to do this part again. Okay, so it says apply a thin layer of the gel base and top coat, which is this here. So we're gonna go ahead and apply a thin layer just to the thumb. All right, so I'm gonna do that whole bottle of the neck thing. Okay, hold on. This needs a little shaking. Give me a second. Shake, shake, shake. That's another thing I saw in these videos too, is that these gel polishes require a lot of shaking because they settle or something. I don't know. So, let's see. All right, now. Gonna do the whole circle. Okay, so I have the base coat on these two fingers. I'm just gonna go ahead and show you guys as I put the base coat on these next two fingers. And it's really kind of difficult to get this base coat on the nails evenly, because this brush is terrible. I mean, sorry, Sensationail. This brush is really bad. It doesn't apply it really evenly to the nail, and I don't know if I just got a bad bottle or if this is the way it is, because the other two aren't like that, so I'm assuming that this is just a really bad bottle. I want to make sure I get the most of it off, because I don't want to apply a lot. And there. Alright, so let me just make sure I cap the free edge. And the thing is that the polish itself has a consistency of like honey. And so it doesn't dry, and you know, I'm in the habit of, oh, let me hurry up before it dries, you know, and fix all my mistakes and stuff like that. And no, you don't have to hurry, because this stuff kind of stays, you know, the way it is until it's cured under the lamp. I also read that if your nails are getting warm underneath when you're curing, that means that you have put on too much polish. So just a little FYI. So I went ahead and got this done. So let's go ahead and cure for 30 seconds. I'm putting all four fingers in there this time. And go. So we're curing for 30 seconds. So now we're going to go to our color, And we're going to pull it out here. It's a really pretty color, I will say that. And this brush is so much better, so. Nice thin coats. That seems to be the key with everybody's gel system. Thin coats. And don't get anything on the cuticle. Okay, maybe that might be a little too thin. Hold on. No matter whose gel system I was looking at, Orly's, Sally Hansen, China Glaze, everybody was saying thin coats. Hold on, let me just kind of even it out here. I don't know if that's a thin coat. Oh. Okay, hold on, let me see. Because I have a nice wide nail bed, so it's kind of easy. Alright, there we go. Good. I'm just doing it. I'm really staying away from the edges so I know that it doesn't look super even and stuff by the cuticles, but I just don't want to get it on the cuticle. I'm being like super, super paranoid about it. Probably more than I need to be, but this is my first time, so you guys are just going to have to forgive me on that one. Just make sure I get all the... all that. Alright, almost there, guys. Almost there. Oh, it's going to be like an hour-long video. Oh, there's no polish on that brush. Hold on. This is just... okay, let's see. Oh, you know what I didn't do? I did not cap the free edge as I was going along. We're going to have to do that. Capping free edge. I probably don't need a whole lot of polish for this. Capping free edge. Capping the free edge. Oops. Again, the polish is still very, very wet. So it's very cool that I can go back and kind of do this kind of stuff. Alright. So there we are. So let's go ahead and cure for 1 minute. Make sure that we didn't get any on our fingers, which we, of course, we did. I mean, all over the fingers. So let's go ahead and take care of that, get that off. Good. I mean, it's everywhere. Okay, so again, guys. Thank you for being patient. I'm probably being a little extra right now. And I don't mean to be. Let's see. The rest of them kind of look okay. Okay. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and cure for 1 minute. Okay, so 1 minute. And then after that, we will come back and do the second coat. Alright, that one went on really bad. It's like the brush, I mean, like look at the shape of the brush for crying out loud. It's just, ugh. Alright, so, and I know that there are kit refreshers that I can buy that'll have like the whole, base coat, top coat, and all that kind of stuff. So I'm just kind of getting this on here as quickly and as evenly as I can. Being challenged and all. And here we go, one more time. This is the last one. So we're just gonna go ahead and I kind of pull, when I do my polish, I kind of pull it over the edge there. I think that kind of helps with longevity with my regular polishes, but who knows, I might be jacking up my nails right now just to see if I'm just capping the free edge here. Alright, we're all done with that. Let's just make sure we didn't get any polish. Oops. Of course, I just put some polish on my nails. Let's see, make sure that we didn't get anything kind of wonky on it this time. Oh, look, I did pretty good. Just make sure there's nothing going on there that... yeah, I can't tell you quite what the smell is. The smell is... It's not highly offensive, but it just kind of smells chemically slash peppery or something like that. I don't know. So we shall see. We are almost done with our first hand. Yay! It only took me like an hour in reality, although this video is probably at the 10-minute mark or 15-minute mark. So hold on. We're almost there. And I still have to do this hand, which I will do off camera completely so I don't bore you guys to tears. Yeah, so did you guys know that I have made over 100 videos? All right, so here we are, fully cured. Oh, I feel I must have some polish underneath here because I can kind of feel it, like my skin is attached to it. Ugh. Okay, no, I pulled away. Okay, so last step we need to do is take our gel cleanser thingy. Let me see. I think this is our gel. We have to take a lint-free wipe. So I'm taking one lint-free wipe and I am getting some of our gel cleanser. I am applying it. Oop, oop, oop. Whoa. Whoa. Wow. Don't pour the whole bottle on like I just did. Don't do that. And I'm just going to kind of do this little thing here that I always see everybody do to kind of take off that moisture layer. Okay, so the nails should be done. This is how they look. Okay. So, whoa, guys, hi. So, okay, I mean, they feel dry, they feel hard. Oh, I must have touched this nail before I cured it and didn't realize it. Oh well. They do smell a little chemical-y, not even gonna lie. But the polish, I have to say, it looks like it came out well. Now try not to be too judgmental on the skills of the painter. It looks like, because I can see like areas where it wasn't too even, but I was really nervous about not getting it on the cuticles and not getting it on the free, you know, on the skin and everything. So I'm sure as I get more practice in, this will not be an issue. So here's the thumb. So I'm gonna go ahead and paint this hand completely and then I'll come back and then we're all set. Okay guys, so I am curing my last, you know, cure process. So I'm putting on the top coat for my right hand and it is curing, so it should be done in now. And at this point I'm turning off my LED and I'm going to get my, you know, my this and this, and I'm going to do that whole, you know, cleansing, carefully pouring it out. Really? Oh, there we go. Okay. So I've got my, and I'm doing my wipey here. Some things that I've learned. Do not do your nails up in the air. Like sometimes, like I caught myself twice because I wanted to kind of get a little closer. So sometimes I'll be like this, or I'll do it kind of like in the air like this. Gel polish will shift. It will move. It will all pool to the front of your nail. So keep your polishes, keep your hands on the table as much as possible. Also, you want to make sure that you keep these little bottles away from the LED light because it will cure the polish in the bottle and that will not be good. The other thing that I learned is that just kind of take your time with it and make sure that you're getting a really nice even coat across the nail. And I obviously need some practice because this is how my nails came out. And like I said, I was a little nervous about putting it on, and you can see like around the cuticles it's not very even, and you know, I have some bare spots and, you know, just little things like that. But again, this was my first time, so you know, I think I did okay for a first time. So at this point what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop the video and I am going to upload this so that you guys can see the process. Hopefully this was a good video. If you guys wouldn't mind letting me know if you like the demo. I can always do more demos of different stuff. If this polish lasts, which I'm really hoping that it will, and with a little bit more practice, I'm gonna pick up a couple more shades to try out, so you know I can do a different demo just showing you the shades, since I kind of showed you the process here. And let me know if that's something that you guys want to see. If you guys have this kit, what was your experience like? Did you really like it? Did it not work for you? Did it really work for you? Did you have any tips that would help maybe somebody else who's doing this for the first time? Let us all know so we can all kind of learn together. So thank you guys for hanging in with this kind of wonky, weird video and all these edits and everything that I'm going to have to put in. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye. Beautiful nails.